Welcome back, folks. Dow Industrials right now down 57. You get the NASDAQ off 38. S&P's off 12.5. Let's go over to our man, Mr. Steve Rhodes, as we do each and every Monday at 20 past the first hour. Don't forget, folks, Steve does an outstanding show every trading day here, 1 to 2 Eastern Standard Time. Also has a great newsletter, Mastering Probability. Now, the way you can get his newsletter, you come over to our website at TFNN. You're going to see it right under featured content. You hit Mastering Probability. You hit subscribe button. You can get that for 1 month for $149. You can get it for 6 months for $695, which is a savings of $199. You can get it for a year for $1,195, which is a savings of $593. They all come with a 30-day money-back guarantee, folks. Everything to gain, nothing to lose. Steve Rhodes.
Well, Tom, I never would have believed it if I hadn't seen it for my own eyes, which is the running of the Kentucky Derby twice. Today, we had the Kentucky Derby in the markets, and it was maximum pressure that was leading until about 6 o'clock. In fact, it opened at maximum pressure, led right from the gates last night when the equity futures opened up at 6 o'clock. And yeah, they held that race until 6 o'clock this morning, and then apparently disqualified twice in a row. Did you get a chance to see that race?
I did. Yeah.
So I saw it from a distance. I mean, I was at a restaurant and there was a TV off in the distance, and you know, I could see that the horse that led, which was maximum security,
yes,
you know, was out in front all the way. Didn't think that it would make it, you know, the entire way there. And I never saw the replay. I just have been too busy with stuff. So what was your take on the race?
So what happened is that when they were going around the turn, what happened, what they think happened, is that the horse heard the crowd and jumped over two lanes.
Oh, really?
And then the guy tried to get him back, and he did get him back, but it was too late. I mean, he hammered those horses, man. So you can't do that. It's a cut and dry deal too, folks. This is not like a, you know, I was looking at it, says, man, you can't go over lanes because horses die like that. I mean, people die like in 2 seconds.
Absolutely.
So that's, you know, it's unfortunate, man. But bottom line is that, you know, imagine 2 tons coming at you. Yeah. So
that
mud was amazing, man.
Absolutely. So today, if talking about maximum pressure, which we saw with the Dow moving lower, and the chart that's up on my screen right now, the Dow equity futures contract, you know, I won't know for sure, but the horse today could be a hammer candle, and that's today's candle session that we have out here. But we won't know until the end of the day. As we speak right now, if the wick on the top of today's candle starts to expand too much to the downside, it won't be a hammer candle. But if it is, the interesting thing about that, Tom, is that we've got an A to B equal CD that formed. If we use as our swing point, and I'm using the May 1st swing point, that's the A point, and I'm taking a look, folks, at the Dow equity futures contract. My B point was really just the following day on May 2nd, and then Friday's move higher set up that C point of the A to B equal CD. Now, this is a four-day pattern. Nonetheless, if we take a look at what this was projecting, it was projecting a minimum price move, the one-to-one, meaning, folks, the distance between the high that we used for our A point and the low, that was May 1st, and then the low on May 2nd, that gave us our price range that once a C point formed, and we didn't know this you know, coming into the close on Friday, but if we just simply add that same distance to the high in the Dow equity futures contract on Friday, which was 26,518, gave us a price projection of 25,975. Now, Tom, the way that I do these A to B equals CD patterns, because it was one of the patterns that I learned very early on, and I used to trade them right when the one-to-one level was hit. And then what I learned was that A to B equals CD patterns only complete at that one-to-one level 60% of the time. So then, being a curious individual, I simply want to understand, well, how am I going to know? You know, if it's 60 to 40 are okay odds, but I wanted to improve my odds. And what I was able to identify was that that D point finished or was more likely to finish when you saw a bullish reversal candle to the downside, or an A to B equals CD to the upside when a bearish reversal candle formed. And so what we have here, just simply even off of the move from the low on March 25th, if we do get a hammer candle today in the Dow equity futures contract, we have what's referred to as a Gartley buy pattern. Now, in a Gartley buy pattern, there's basically what I like to say 5 different potential outcomes. And those first 4 outcomes are nothing more than retracements of that A to D leg out here. And so drawn on my screen, and folks, those retracements are your 0.382 retracement. By the way, that was at 26,221. We're well beyond that. The 0.618 retracement level is 26,401. We're trading at 26,407. Yes, we got beyond that, but that is a natural level. So if this is nothing more than a true counter trend rally, the Dow Equity Futures contract, could be at that counter trend move here. But if it's a hammer candle, and because today would really be a wide-ranging bar, this would suggest to me that price is going to go at least test the highs of last Friday, which is really at about the 0.786 retracement level, 26,528. Anything above that gets us back to our, as you coined it, 100% move of a move out there. And I owe you a big royalty check because I like to use that. I think it's a great expression. And it really helps people to understand that price has made it all the way back to where that pattern began. Now, the fifth outcome, and we don't know this yet, and we wouldn't know this unless price was able to overtake those highs, is that the Gartley buy pattern in this case here actually turns into a new A to B equals CD to the upside. And folks, just to give you the conservative price projection on that, here, I'll just go ahead and use this. What we would be looking at, just the one-to-one level, would take us up into the 27,246 area. So that's one pattern that's out there that I'm watching. And if we take a look at we talked about this last week, Tom. We are headed into what's referred to as the unfavorable seasonal cycle, the so-called expression of sell in May. But what we're seeing take place just since May began is not unusual. When we take a look at the seasonal cycle that has occurred over the last 87 years, and what we can see is that really between the 1st of May and the 3rd week in May, around May 19th or so, we see a lot of this up and down movement. So what we're actually seeing today is really kind of normal out here, or the new normal. And so this jockeying around, so to speak, I guess bringing in the vernacular from yes, from a Kentucky Derby, you know, could go on for another couple of weeks out here. The thing that I want folks to focus on, let me just share with you at least this one chart. And the question is, because there are topping signals that I have in most, in all of the equity futures contracts, but this chart here for the ES Mini really tells the story. And the story is this. Tom, there's six green arrows on this chart. And this is using the TAS market profiles, and it's using the daily profiles, all in blue horizontal levels. And in order for there to be a change in trend, we are going to need to see a close below the bottom of the box. Each of these green arrows show simply buying opportunities where price pushed down to the bottom of the box. Clearly today was a buying opportunity as another attempt to try to close below. And the level here, folks, is 28.95. Look, I don't know what's going to happen overnight. What I do know is if we see a close below 28.95, we've seen a change in trend in the market. And right now,
you know, it's wild too, Steve, is that, you know, if we do, let's picture that the market goes up the rest of the week.
Yeah.
Then you actually have a hanging man, you know.
Yeah. Absolutely.
You'll love it. Listen, folks, you can get Steve's newsletter. Come over to our website at TFNN. You see running the featured content, Master Probability. Steve, have a great one. Safe one. Look forward to the show tomorrow.
Thanks, Tom.
Stay right there, folks. Come right back.